Hello, Basu this side. Please endorse, subscribe and like our YouTube channel. Your support is very well appreciated from our end and it's very important for us. Today's nugget is insulin sensitivity. Constantly we keep hearing this word, insulin sensitivity, insulin resistance, insulin roller coaster, in fitness parlance and in medical parlance. What is this insulin? Insulin is a hormone in the blood which is released to lower your sugar levels whenever you eat food. It's as simple as that. It is made by the beta cells in the pancreas, and every time you eat food, insulin is released into your system to lower the blood sugar levels in your body. And constantly it is also released for your glucose metabolism. So you need energy, right? So insulin also helps the glucose to convert into energy, and it also stores energy for future use. But what happens when you constantly do this for X number of years? One fine day, the pancreas are going to get very tired and say, I've had enough, I'm not going to release insulin. That's when your doctor or your nutritionist says, sir, you're borderline into diabetes, you need to be careful, you need to probably start a medication, you need to watch what you eat, you need to start exercising, and all those things, we've heard it so many times. So what is insulin sensitivity? Is it a good word or a bad word? Insulin sensitivity is fine. I mean, if your insulin sensitivity is an optimum measure, then you're fine. But if they say insulin resistance, then it is a bad word. That means the door is closing and the rate at which your insulin is secreted by the pancreas is now getting tired and it wants external help. We don't want to get into that situation. And if you hear this word, low insulin sensitivity, bad word again. So that means the door is again closing, so be very careful. So constantly you need to make changes in your lifestyle, I would say every 5 years. Your body is not the same. At 20s it reacts very different, then when you reach 30 it's different, when you reach 35 it's different. So every 5 years probably you need to do a reassessment of yourself and take a time out and assess what you eat and how you move and what type of exercises you do. So insulin roller coaster is not good for you, because you don't want your insulin to spike up every time you eat food, and then when you don't eat food it drops. Food up, food down, food up, food down. This up and down, up and down, up and down thing into your system is going to enter into a beautiful roller coaster, which is again not good for you. We want to cut down this bloody circus, and we need to choose the right type of foods. Foods which are nutritionally balanced, foods which give you the right type of nutrients, and the right timing is also very, very important. You need to time it well and you need to use it judiciously to your advantage. So again, eat well, move well and stay healthy. Thank you.